Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Good morning. There we go. Good morning, church. It is great to be together. I'm so excited to see many faces here. Well, this is a special time and a special day. First of all, happy Independence Day, everybody. Yes. You know, our country is nothing if not complex. But God is in the mess and perfects as we go. And that promise comes from the Bible, and it also comes from Wesley. So I believe it. So welcome, everybody. We are, I'm sure everyone's anxious to meet our brand new pastor, Pastor Joanne Schott. And she will be saying something, but it will be a little bit later on. So just be excited and be ready to wait for that and be ready for it. Let's look at this centering thought for this week. Anybody who has paid attention to their inner life of prayer or read history books surely recognizes that life and love are always cumulative, growing, and going somewhere that is always new and always more. Let's think about this as we contemplate something new and something more. Let's sing, shall we?
We gather together to ask the Lord's blessing. He chases and hastens His will to make known. The wicked oppressed now sees from distressing. Sings praises to His name, forgets not His own. Beside us to guide us, our God with us joining, ordaining, maintaining His kingdom divine. So from the beginning, the fight we are winning. Now Lord is the sign, all glory be thine. We all do extol.
In this day when we celebrate freedom, O Lord, make us free. Well, this is when we begin our time together in prayer and thanksgiving. That's great. Well, first of all, congratulations to have a daughter heading off to college. You know, there's a whole package of prayers wrapped around that. You want good things, you don't want bad things, you want the experiences, but you want them to be, want that person to be independent and successful. But that comes for a lot. And for many of us, you know, who are kind of realizing now just how badly the plants around our homes got trashed, and we're kind of digging out of that. For farmers, it's a livelihood issue. And as you brought up, absolutely, it's been a health issue for the animals and whatnot. So, yeah, prayers for all the farmers. Dean?
That there will be no fires caused by foolishness.
Yeah. So, do we pray for common sense? The last time I checked, it's not so common anymore. Just saying, but... any more prayers? Can we take this to prayer? Let's be in prayer, shall we? Gracious Heavenly Father, we come to you with our hands and our hearts open. You have heard the prayers of the people today, and we know that we can take everything, anything to you, and we can depend on the strength you provide us for another day. Be with us, guide our loved ones, guide those who hurt. Help them recognize that their strength is in you, and through you, we can all become stronger. And we can be the people that are there for other people, because that is what you call us to do. You have given us such a perfect example in your Son, and that is why we are here, to recognize the life in Christ and to follow in his footsteps and to speak the words that he taught his people. As we say together, our Father,
morning comes from 2 Corinthians 5, verses 16 through 20. So from now on, we regard no one from a worldly point of view. Though we once regarded Christ in this way, we do so no longer. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old one has gone. The new one is here. All this is from God, who reconciled us to him through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation, that God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting people's sins against them. And he has committed to us the message of reconciliation. We are therefore Christ's ambassadors, as though God were making his appeal through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. And now it's time for some ministry news.
Good morning, tent people. A couple of things to tell you about. As some of you know, Shape Northwest has been using part of our facility this summer. They are like a day camp organization. There's kind of two parts to it. The younger part, K through third grade, is using our basement and the lower yard and the playground. And then the older ones, fourth through eighth grade, I think it is, they get on, they get in a van and they do outings and excursions during the day. So you will see Monday through Friday, you'll see the kids up here. And then after hours, you'll see that they park their big van down below. And then sometimes, like this last weekend, they had a you know, kind of a retreat for the staff, and they left a couple of cars parked in the upper parking lot. So that's what's going on here on the on weekdays is that, and it'll last until I think the 20th of August. And it's kind of nice, you know, they do pay us a little bit, so that's kind of a little a bonus that we can share and at the same time get a little spiff out of it. There is one thing. They do their own janitorial. As you maybe know, we don't have a hired janitorial service for the church at this point. It hasn't been needed so much the last year or so. They do their own janitorial. Bear in mind, this is a couple of young 20-somethings and a part-time teenager. So, need I say more? No, I need say no more. Except that they could use a little boost. So, Bob and I have gone a couple of times, done a little mopping up here and a little cleaning the bathroom there. If you feel that Jesus is laying it on your heart, that you want to help do a little of that on some of the weekends, would you please see me after the service? And maybe we can get a little team going here and give them a little extra assist in that. So it's just a little. Moving right along. Yeah, Roger.
I just needed to add a note. Since Shape Northwest is here, if you're in the building and leaving, don't arm the system while they're still here. And I'll try and remind them not to arm the system while we're still here, because both of those things happened this week. And also, the building was left open because they parked their cars here for the weekend, but we didn't know it. So just watch the security a little bit.
Thanks. Thank you. Then on Tuesday night, Ad Council is meeting mostly in person here at 7. There will also be Zoom access for those who can't be in person. For those of you who don't really know or need a reminder, Ad Council is made up basically of the committee chairs of all the various committees. And then there are a few lay leaders like me and Tyler Brinkman. The business of the church is discussed. The hopes of the church is discussed. New ideas for what we could be doing is discussed. How we could improve what we're doing is discussed. So even if you are not an actual member of Ad Council, you are certainly welcome to come to Ad Council meetings. It's a great way to find out what the heck's going on. And sometimes something turns up like, gee, we could use some extra janitorial for Shape Northwest. And it might really speak to you. So, you know, it's an opportunity. I hope that we see some of you there on Tuesday this week. Thank you.
Thanks, Jan. Well, I guess it's my turn again. Oddly, I wasn't expecting to give this presentation, but because last week we got overheated, right? So too hot for church. So we are mushing ahead this week with our capital funds drive for the replacement of our roof. Let me tell you, I am a member of the capital improvement team, and we've been working since 2015 on, to determine the various needs of our church facility. And we have a beautiful building here that helps us carry out both our missions and our ministries. So we take the facility and the stewardship of that very seriously. Our most pressing need right now is the replacement of our roof and the heating and the air conditioning systems. One of the major expenses involved is this upgrade of adding high efficiency air conditioning to the sanctuary, which we have never had before. We have had some heat, which rises very quickly and very inefficiently, but no air conditioning. We know by recent experience that high temperatures are a part of our future. We believe this is the time to make these upgrades. So our planning team realized that adding ductwork to the sanctuary could devastate the aesthetics by obscuring our beautiful stained glass windows and the interior design of the church by unsightly, very, very large heating vent pipes. So we worked with the HVAC contractor to design a solution. By changing the roof line slightly, and I think there's a slide here, and I recognize it's hard to see, but we can, you can look at this up close and personal later on too. By changing the roof line slightly, we can accommodate the necessary ductwork and make these changes at the time of the roof replacement. And this project will require a loan from the Methodist Foundation. To secure the loan, we must provide 30% of the total cost from our funds. Now, our finance committee has suggested an amount from our general fund that they felt can be safely used without overspending, leaving us approximately $50,000 to raise in order to meet the loan requirements. We are proposing a short campaign. Hopefully, we are asking for people to give beyond the $50,000 if possible, because we would like to have seed money for the next things that lie before us, like better lighting in the sanctuary. We have a long list, believe me. This may seem like a daunting goal, but we have a history of generosity. Some of you may not know that in the 90s, the size of this building was doubled as we added a kitchen, fellowship hall, bathrooms, more Sunday school rooms upstairs, over an equal amount of space below. And more recently, of course, people have stepped up to build the playground and to complete some major sanctuary upgrades. So based upon our giving history, our finance committee has a practical tool that they have developed to help everyone understand how y'all can participate in this capital drive. This slide shows the total number of givers that we currently have shown on our books based upon their yearly giving. And using these ranges as a benchmark, we are asking for your prayerful consideration to pledge an amount somewhere in the area of what is on the amount per giver column to the right. Now, this is extra giving above the monthly gifts, or what we like to call second mile giving. We know that some of us can give more, and some of us cannot give as much. And if the amount you pledge requires more time, that's not a problem for us. We can work that out. We basically will work this out based upon what we see for the pledges. So we would encourage you to prayerfully consider this. It's obvious the need. We've been putting out buckets to catch the drips for the last 2 years or more. Members of the capital improvement team will be here after the service to answer any questions you have, and we can have a little closer look at these slides, and hopefully we can raise the roof on this project. So thank you for considering this. Thank you for your time, and it is our sincere prayer that God will bless these efforts and that our stewardship will be entirely to the glory of God. Thanks be to God. So, I guess we sing now. Okay. And of course, what I should have said ahead of that is we receive so much from God and from our family here. We give back in joy and gratitude. And so as you give your offerings, whenever you give your offerings, and there is an offering plate here that we will not pass, but we will have here to the end of the service, we encourage you to recognize the gifts you give, the gifts you receive, and the fellowship that comes with that. And may we strive to continue in that fellowship to give and to see the needs of others in Christ. Let's stand and sing if we can.
So take me as you find me, all my fears and failures, and fill my life with you. I give my life to follow everything I believe in. God, I surrender. Save me.
singing, everybody. I'd like to bring those old ones back. Nancy, thank you for reading.
Take my mask off so you can hear me and so I won't fog up my glasses. This reading is from Isaiah 43, verse 19. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland. From Jeremiah 29, verse 11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future.
Dean just mentioned, oh, there's a flyover that's going to happen at 11 o'clock. Yeah. Don't let it scare you. Let's see.
Philippians 4, 6 through 7. I know this well. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Amen.
For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him.
Amen. Now, this praise song is probably new to many of you, but I think you'll get the knack of it. It's a great, great praise song from We the Kingdom.
It's his fault. It's not mine.
No, of course it is.
It's okay, Bob. You'll get the knack of it.
You know, it's funny. We were just talking about that with Pastor Joy last week. About how anyway.
Two.
is waiting, God so loved the world.
And I have been at this church for 15 years. This is the beginning of our fourth pastor at this church. I was raised in the Methodist Church, and I have come to understand that pastors come and go, and each one with its gifts and its talents, God-given gifts and talents, each one has something to bring to the church. Since I've been here, starting with Derek McGuckin, who has pushed us in leadership, and James Murphy, who helped us with teaching us, good teacher, and pushing us outside the walls of our church, whether we wanted to go or not. And then Meredith, Pastor Meredith, who took us and helped us with our relationship walls, and teaching us that everybody, every single person is a beloved child of God, with value and worth. And a lot of this took us beyond our comfort zone and helped us to grow and helped us down that spiritual path. And so it's exciting to have someone else come, and I don't know where God's leading us next, but he wants to use Pastor Joanne to take us even further. So it's exciting to see what's going to happen. Pastor Joanne shared with me that she was born in Ohio and has a lot of relatives still there. She hopes to go back there in August to visit. She has been many places in her pastoral career. She's been to Seattle, Alaska. She was up in Alaska in Anchorage for 8 years. She went to Eastern Washington, Moses Lake, and through the course of her being led by the Lord, she has come to Vancouver Heights and now here. So it is with great pleasure that I introduce Pastor Joanne Schett.
Here I am. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
It is a privilege to be here. I want to thank everyone. I want to thank Roger and his moving crew for three flights of steps and then some. I found out that Wayfair will deliver to the third floor for only $10. And so if all of you movers turn in a voucher to me for every trip up the steps, $10. I'll be glad to turn in the bill to the conference. I want to thank Lori and the Staff Parish Relations Committee for the Megans and for Meredith and for everyone who has made the transition here as wonderful as it has been. When the bishop spoke to me a while ago, a month ago, I said, no, I'm not moving. And guess what I did? Because that's what we do when we're United Methodists. One of my favorite parts, and it's funny the things that you claim and then you have to live into, right? You claim these parts of your faith, and then God's like, okay, let's test that. Do you really, really believe that? John Wesley said, the world is my parish. And I claimed that early on in seminary, in my faith, and I have not only served churches throughout our country, I have been in many places in the world, and my favorites have been Africa and Russia, but there are others. And if you visit my office, you're going to see little remnants of them. During my time here, I plan to be in Russia for at least a good long time. But I'm excited to see where God is taking you and where God has been with you. I'm very intentionally ending the service, not preaching, but introducing myself. I want to know who you are. I want to know the gifts that you bring. I don't want to step on anyone's toes, and I certainly don't want any of your jobs. I will have enough to do all by myself. My specific call is related to outreach to marginalized people. I started Megan, my first career, I was a speech pathologist. I didn't know if you knew that or not. So my first career, I worked with kids, and I'm really glad the kids are here today. Back at my church, back my previous church, there weren't so many kids because of the COVID, and we wanted to be inside and not outside. Outside means the kids can play. And I love that. So do you guys want to come on up here? If I sit down up here, is that easier? And then you guys can sit. There's a tricky thing about microphones and speakers, and I'm trying to pay good attention to that. You guys don't have to be on the ground if you don't want to be. It's up to you. So when I was your age, this is the deal. My mom and my dad and my grandma and my grandpa and my uncle, basically everybody that I knew went to church all day long on Sunday. They were always at the church. And so I went with them. And it's interesting the things that I learned just by watching. They had beautiful stained glass just like you do, and I like to look at the pictures and the images. And when I looked up at the pastor, I was actually kind of bored. Because it was almost always an older guy. Older guys are great. We love them. They move furniture, for heaven's sakes. They're helpful. But he always wore a black suit or robe. And he was very serious. He never once smiled that I could tell. And so I was kind of afraid of the pastor. It's really important to me that people are not afraid of me. And so hence, look at the hair, guys. Right? And the toes. And, you know, we're just getting started with what this is going to be. When I was a speech therapist, I learned some important signs, and I'm going to just show two of them to you guys and see if you know them. Do you know what this is?
It's an X. It's
kind of
like a hug.
Yeah. It's kind of like a hug. Megan Green, do you know what this is? The way that I'm doing with the microphone, nobody can tell. It's love. The most important thing that I've learned in church is that God loves us. No matter what. God even loves caterpillars. God loves everything that God has created. God loves us unconditionally. And God doesn't just love us. God loves everyone we are ever going to meet. Even if we don't like them, God still loves them. Right? That's an important thing. The other sign that I really like is this one. Do you guys know this one? And when you do this one, you got to smile a little bit. Try it.
Happy.
It's not only happy, it's beautiful. So it's taking your hand across your whole face and smiling because it's so good. Right? I am, and I, you know what? This is not something I don't look in the mirror and say, oh, Duane, you're so beautiful. No, I don't do that. But God does. God looks at my face, and God looks at my heart, and God says, you are the most beautiful Joanne I have ever seen. And I believe God does that with our caterpillars and with our Maddies and our Olivias. God says, you are the most beautiful that I could ever imagine you to be. And if that is the only thing we ever learn in church, I think that is plenty good. What do you think? I'm so excited to get to hear about your stories, about your families, but also the things that you like to do. What are the things that are fun for you? Is there anything you want to tell me today? Yeah. They have a slip and slide and a pool.
I knew about the pool, but I didn't know about
it. Oh my goodness. Wouldn't it be so fun if the church had a slip and slide? Oh, and I've got another idea about slip and slides that involves some other things. I'm a little afraid to tell you in front of people. All right. What else is fun for you to do in the summertime? Yes. You play the piano? I want to hear you play the piano sometime. Right? And maybe it'll be just you playing and I'm listening, or maybe it'll be even more than that. But we can decide, all right? What else do you guys like to do? Oh, you forgot. That happens to me all the time. Oh my gosh. But so this is the deal. We have to finish pretty soon because there's going to be planes flying and we don't want to compete with that. But we are going to have shortcake and we are also going to have a lot of time together, right? So if you can think of something you like to do, give me a call. Right? All of you.
There it is. North Field 11.
Come over here and look. With your families, and I'm going to bless everybody together. Well, you can't top that, can you? So we're not going to try. I hope you all heard me, right? What do you think my favorite color is?
Blue.
Nope.
Red. Purple.
It's every color. Purple's pretty good. I don't know. I change my mind all the time, but today it's blue because it's what I'm wearing. The reality is that we're going to make a lot of assumptions about one another, and the only way we're going to get beyond that is a lot of conversation and some very real time. And so I just pray that God's going to bless us together over the next many years, that we will find God in our midst, that we will find God in one another, and that we will share God with the whole wide world, because the whole wide world is in desperate need, beginning with the community of Richfield, right, and our neighbors here. May God bless you and keep you. May God make God's face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. And may the Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Creator, the Redeemer, and the Sustainer.
I hope that you can all stay after service and join us in having some strawberry shortcake. It should be coming out that door any minute.
Bring it on. Thank you, everyone. And if you have any questions about the stewardship drive, come see us.